Hi there, this is Tammy, and today we're looking at antiseptic swabs. We have many to choose from, but the question is, which one do I use when and why? What is informing your practice when you choose to grab one of the small wipes versus one of the sticks or the swabs? Well, we're going to talk about that right after this. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So we have a variety of options, and that's because we have a variety of procedures that we're doing for our patients that require us to know which one to grab and why. So let's just start. We'll take the Loris alcohol pad here first because we often use this one in clinical settings for starting IVs, for cleaning sites for blood draws, etc. I've tried to find out what size of an area this swab would be most effective in with its antiseptic properties, and I cannot find any research that tells me that. So if you have any insight, please put it in the comments to share so that we can be better together. Sticking with the small wipes, we're going to go to the chlorhexidine. This is a product by 3M. And what's interesting is 3M has a fantastic website, and it talks about their products and it gives you some very definitive information. For example, I have an application time of 30 seconds for a dry site or a 2-minute application time for a moist site. Further on the lower half, I have the small swab and it tells me it's good for a 6 by 7 centimeter area. So we're going to take a look at what that looks like in practice. So beside my arm is a 6 by 7 dressing. This would be the area size that our chlorhexidine and most likely our alcohol swab would be most effective in. If you were to take your alcohol swab and clean the entire length of this arm, we can see that in fact this arm is larger than the dressing size, and I may not have the best disinfectant antiseptic skin prep possible. So instead, we really want to just focus on this small area, okay, which is essentially the size of the back of my hand. So we're going to take our swab, and you can go in a back and forth motion, or you can do circles, but you really want to get a 30-second scrub to maximize that antiseptic property. Let it air dry, and we are good to go. In moving up to the small swab, I have a 10 by 11 centimeter area that I can clean with this product. So what I have here next is a cutout of a 10 by 11 centimeter area. If I were to place my arm in this area, you can see that I have about the third to a half of my arm that I can cover with my swab stick. From my elbow down, it's the upper half of my forearm. From my wrist up, it'll be the lower half of my forearm and considerable edges there as well before I hit those borders. So taking out our small swab stick, we can then go ahead and clean. Remember, we need a 30-second scrub. So that means we can go back and forth in one direction for 15 seconds and then flip it and do side to side for another 15 seconds. The mechanical action is critical to help remove and reduce microorganisms on the skin tissue. So let's talk about this green package. This is the mystery one for me. So this is a chlorhexidine swab minus the alcohol, zero alcohol in this swab. Okay, and that's an important distinction from the red package. This one has alcohol, no alcohol. Now the difference here is the surface area. Even though this is the same size swab as my chlorhexidine with alcohol, the surface area here reverts back down to that 5 to 6 centimeters. In addition, if I'm using a dry area, 30 seconds scrub is okay, but if I'm working on a moist area, I need to do a full 4-minute scrub for this to be effective. Again, another question I had when looking at these two products in particular was, I noticed on the green package it says not sterile. But the red package doesn't say sterile or not sterile. There's just simply no claim here. So I did just a little bit more research on this. The information I was able to find indicates that we cannot guarantee that this is a sterile swab, and therefore it should not be put into your sterile field. And the third swab I want to talk about today is the povidone-iodine prep pad. This is another powerful antiseptic that is used in the clinical setting. Again, I was unable to locate information on its surface area, but I did find some rather important clinical considerations in choosing between alcohol, chlorhexidine, and povidone-iodine. So let's look at that next. So when it comes to the povidone-iodine solutions, there are definitely some clinical considerations that we need to think about before we use this as a treatment method as well. The first one is, do they have any thyroid issues? Because there is iodine in here, and this iodine will be absorbed through the skin, through the wound. If you're using it to clean the meatus, it will also be absorbed that way as well. And it can cause issues with our thyroid levels. The second one is, for women who are considering conceiving or they are pregnant, this iodine can actually cause problems with the fetus itself or with the sperm that are trying to impregnate the ova. And the third one is, if patients are on lithium, we want to monitor them and make sure that we choose maybe an alternate method, because there is some contraindications with taking lithium and using povidone-iodine. Now, the alcohol swab also might impact your blood glucose readings. There is some mixed research regarding this, and the research revolves around whether the first drop or second drop would be a better, more accurate reading of a patient's blood glucose. In 2017, Foos conducted a study and found that if the blood did not form a round drop, that there was significant alcohol dilution in the blood sample. She also found that between drop one and drop two, there was not a clinically significant change in the blood glucose reading. In terms of determining your patient's blood alcohol level, the alcohol pads were found to not cause any impact to the actual blood alcohol level of your patient. Now, you'll want to check with your agency to confirm their policy as to how they want you to proceed using these items. So today's video came from a question of, what does inform your practice? I was curious about some of these swabs and these pads, and I hope that this will help you as well in your practice. If you've got some other information, please share it below in the comments, because together we're stronger. And until next time, make it a great day.